Methane, which is the main constituent of natural gas, is also a powerful greenhouse gas. It's 25 to 85 times higher global warming potential than CO2.
So we need to understand what different sources are contributing to the methane budget, to how much we see in the atmosphere and how it's changing from year to year.
And so the issue is that the measurement of the mass balance at the top level, or from satellites sometimes even, consistently comes up with a larger number than what you get from the bottom level. And so the purpose of the Fayetteville Reconciliation Study was to take a basin, the Fayetteville, do reconciliation between these different granularities of measurements. So we could say, why is it that these detailed measurements don't agree with this aircraft measurement? The intent of the study was to measure it at the level we could afford to, every aspect of the oil and gas infrastructure in the basin.
To get everybody out together at the same time in the same field, to measure emissions at the facility level, extrapolate them for the basin scale, and compare with what we would get at the same time when we had an aircraft flying around. So comparing apples and apples, which had never been done before.
So now we have three ways of looking at the same area in space. So we've got mass balance at the aircraft level, we've got the add up all the facilities at the middle level, and then we can add up all the devices at the bottom level. And in theory, they should agree, okay? But the problem is they don't always agree. So one hypothesis would be is that something about the bottom measurement is not at the same timing as the top measurement. What we try to do in this study then is to get rid of that temporal variation problem. So we measured well sites, over 200 well sites. We measured compressor stations that are between the well sites and the transmission system where the gas is being moved out. We measured compressor stations on the transmission system. I think at one point we had over 60 people on the ground in the Fayetteville making these measurements. You have to have access to the facilities to make the measurements. You have to have some knowledge of what's happening at those facilities at the same time, and you have to coordinate all these things together. So it's like this planned experiment with a bunch of active partners, so that you have to have the participation from the bottom layer, what's happening on the ground, all the way to making sure the weather cooperates for the airplane flying overhead. All has to happen at once.
And so if we have perfect weather, which means the wind is blowing in a direction across the entire field for the entire time that we're there, the wind direction, wind speed is very consistent. When we have conditions like this, then we can do an aircraft mass balance and to quantify emissions from the entire field.
What we found in the study was that there's maintenance activities happening during the day and during the week. These maintenance activities cause short, large releases of gas. Unfortunately, or fortunately, during that same period is when we're doing our measurements. And we may see that elevated emission during the time we're making the measurement. So the aircraft, for example, may fly through that plume. One way to think about this is that, let's suppose a friend of mine and I both observe the same vehicle in traffic. And he comes back and says that traffic is moving at 60 miles per hour. That car is moving 60 miles per hour. So that's the answer. And I observe the vehicle and I say it's moving 30 miles per hour. Okay? Now it doesn't mean he's wrong or I'm wrong. It just means we observed the system, the car, at a different time of day. And that's roughly what's happening here. The aircraft gets a valid measurement for when it's flying downwind. The annual average estimate of emissions is a valid measurement, annually averaged, but they're not the same thing. And so what we showed is there's a very specific reason why they're not the same thing. And that closes the gap. To do this type of study, we need research independence. We have to have an independent statistical sampling. But in order to do that actual measurement, we have to have the cooperation from our industry partners. And we received excellent cooperation, not just for access to their sites, but also to learn about how they were doing things and what activities were occurring on those sites.
I think what we've really shown with very carefully collected measurements, both on the ground and in the aircraft, is that the emission question is a much more complex system than what we envisioned before.
The global warming impact of natural gas is highly dependent on how much methane escapes without being burned.